Hello, very good evening to all the students, teachers and parents who have joined us. We will be starting just in few minutes. Very welcome on the day three of celebration Scratch Week with PictoBlocks.
Yes, hi Uday, hi Kunj, welcome all of you. Welcome to the day three Scratch Week celebration with PictoBlocks. Hi Pal, hi Rakshana. I welcome all of you to the day three of a Scratch Week celebration with PictoBlocks. Hello Nitin, hello others, welcome all. So Chinmay, your question is like on which website you need to go. You need to go on pictoblocks.ai. On that website, you can just, that is a web app of our PictoBlocks. So like a web version, you can go over there and perform an activity. Hi Pratik. It's a very pleasure to see all of you here.
So students, we will be starting in just few minutes. Till the time, I would request you all, if you have downloaded the PictoBlocks in your laptop, PCs, and Android phone, it's wonderful. If not, please download it from the links I am sharing you. Also, do not forget to go and visit our web version of PictoBlocks.
Yes, Pratik, we will going to share the link. Yes, see, Ayush sir has already shared the link over there.
So for Shivam has asking for repeat the course of yesterday. So Shivam, we are sharing the recorded video for you and it's on YouTube. So you can always go and revise the session which we have taken. So I'll share you the link for yesterday also.
Yeah. Yes, Daksh, you can make a multiplayer game in PictoBlocks also. So as you can see in the chat, Ayush sir has shared the link with you. You can go on that link and you can find the replay video of the previous session.
So I think what I'm going to do is we'll wait for one more minute and I'll just disable the chat and float out all the links so that everyone can get those links. Okay.
Exactly.
So this is the link for downloading the PictoBlocks in your laptop and desktop. Link for the Google Play Store to download it in your Android phones. Link to the very new web version of the PictoBlocks. And let me also share the link for the last 2 days replay video. Yeah.
Yeah, so here on the chat, you are having all the things. Ayushar has shared all the links, important links with you. So you guys can just follow up these links. Okay. Yes. So, and I hope that all of you had tried that artificial intelligence session things, like the whatever the codes we have made yesterday, you have tried that things and learned something new. Yes. Okay. So I think we should just start our today's topic.
Yeah, Shalin, I think we are good to go. Yeah. So students, I'm enabling your chat. If you find any trouble, please let us know.
Yeah. Okay, great. So I hope like my audio and the video is properly visible and audible to you, right? If it is, can you please show me the thumbs up? So that I can just start our topic. Okay, great. So like in yesterday's part, we have learned about an artificial intelligence, and we all have get to know about how good the artificial intelligence is, right? We have learned how we can make a face recognition based face expression detection, right? So now in today's part, we are going to learn about machine learning, right? So I'm sharing my screen with you. And let's us learn about machine learning now. Okay, just a second. Yeah. Is my screen is visible? Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay, great. So let's begin this beautiful journey of machine learning. Okay, yeah. So in this part, in our today's session, we are going to get to know about what exactly the machine learning is, machine learning process, and we are today going to make a very wonderful activity of a face mask detector, where we are going to check whether the person has wear the mask or not, right? And preparing for the competition. So first of all, let's start with machine learning. So how human learns? As you know, we all are humans, and how actually we learns, that is a very tricky part, no? Okay, so first, basically human learns from four mistakes, right? And the mistakes are human learns for the four steps. So first is sense environment. Second is analyze information. Third is decide and act. And fourth is increase the knowledge. But like what exactly these four steps are? Suppose just take an example. If you go to solve your maths examination paper, right? So first of all, what you do, you just see the questions, right? Then you just analyze the questions, like what exactly you need to do over here. Then you just decide what answer you should put, like you just perform all the calculation and decide what answer you should put. And suppose if you fail like to give the proper answer, or if you missed some steps, and when you came home, you realize those silly mistakes. Yeah, I had just forgot that steps, right? So what you do for the next time when you go for the maths paper, you remember those mistakes and learn from those mistakes, right? It means basically you are just increasing your knowledge, right? So this is the four steps how the human learns. There is a very well-known proverb, like a human learns from the mistakes. The mistakes makes the man perfect, right? Because the human learning itself says like the human will going to learn the things when it will going to perform the mistakes. Right, so I hope this four steps are properly understood by you. The first is sense environment, second is analyze information, third is decide and act, and fourth is increase the knowledge. Okay, yeah, great. So now we are going to like from where human going to learn these things. So our first step is sensing the environment, right? So how human sense the environment? You all know, like a human have the five sensors: eyes, ears, tongue, hand, like your body from where you can touch the things, and your nose from where you can smell the things. This all the five senses perform the activity, and the things are getting hit to the brain, and the brain will going to give you the reaction, like how you need to react. Just suppose if there is a fire and if you try to touch the fire, right? So you are touching with the hand. So suddenly you just pull up your hand. How? Because your brains give you the command to pull up the hand, right? So basically these are the five senses from where you can sense the environment, right? But why it is required for? Because see, once we perform the sense the things, then this sensing related things is basically getting passed for analyzing the information. This sensing related things are getting passed for analyze the information. And once we analyze the things, right? Like if it is a fire, we have analyzed the things. Yeah, it is a fire. So what you will do? You will just pull up your hand, right? So you have decided something, like what you need to do, right? You have decided to pull up your hand. If you have not pulled up your hand, basically you will get burned, right? You will get hurt, right? So you have decided to pull up your hand. And when the next time when someone will going to tell you to go and touch the fire, will you really going to touch the fire? Not at all. Because you know, you have now an idea, like a fire is a dangerous thing. So this is the way how actually the human learns. Okay, great. So now machine learning, what exactly the machine learning is? So machine learning is the process of a machines learn how to act by themselves without any human intervention, right? Here what happened? Machine tried to learn by itself. We are like how the human learns, it tried to learn by itself only, no? In the same way, machine also tries to learn by itself, do the activities by itself and complete the task. Okay, but in the between whole stage, a human intervention is not required. But at an initial stage, that is the starting stage only, the human intervention is required for making the things. Then later on, the things works automatically, right? Just take an example, like you know Alexa, we speak something and according to that, Alexa will give you the response, right? So basically the human intervention is required while making an Alexa, but later on, there is no human intervention is required. All the things are working automatically, right? So machine learning is the process of a machines learn how to act by themselves without any human intervention. It is basically getting a computer to perform a task without explicitly programmed to do so, right? So basically here the computer will going to perform a task without any human intervention, and basically we are going to perform the program at an initial level, and later on all the things will going to work automatically. This is what the machine learning is. Okay, so but do we require to give some input to the machines? Yes, at an initial level, as I told you earlier, initial level the human intervention is required, but later on no human intervention is required. The things will going to perform automatically only. Yeah, so here you can see input, model and output. So what does that mean? We are going to make a model. Just to take an example, I have make a model of a dog versus cat classifier. So what I need to do over here, I want to make a model in the way like whenever I will show the image of a cat, it will going to show me, yeah, this is a cat. And whenever I'm going to show the image of a dog, it will say, yeah, this is a dog, right? So, but before that, machine doesn't know what does the cat mean, what does the dogs means. So we have trained it, and in the model, we have given the input and it will going to give you the output. Okay. Now, the main and important part about machine learning, there are two important parts, like steps in the machine learning. The first is a training and second is testing. But what does the training and the testing exactly means? So Training means like before exam for the past 5 to 6 months, you do the lot of studies, right? You basically trained yourself for the exam. You do the lots of do the all time study, performs all the question, perform all the mathematical calculations, right? So basically you are getting trained yourself, right? And what is testing? The examination time. The examination, you just give your test, no? And based on test, you will get your marks. Right? So in the same way, it happens in the machine learning too. At an initial level, we give the lots of an images to the machine so that based on that, it will going to perform training. Okay. And after it perform the training, we will test it. Okay. And in the testing part, it will going to show you whether your model is working fine or not. So in the input image, we will going to give some input image of a dog and a cat. And in the model, that is our program, it from our input image will go throughout the model and it will going to give you the output. Like if I give the image of a cat, then it will going to give me the output as yes, it is a cat. And if I give the images of a dog, then it will going to give me the output as yeah, it is a dog. Okay. So is the machine learning concept is clear to you? Have you understand the slide? If yes, please just show me the thumbs up in the chat. Okay, great. Yeah. So see, as I told you the example of a dog, a cat and all, right? So here you can see I have given the image of a cat as an input, right? And in the model, I have made my program. And yes, as I made my program, the cat image will going into the my program. And accordingly, it will going to give me the output. And here the output is cat. But suppose if I give the image of a dog, will my model will give me the output as a cat? Not at all, because we have performed a great training. And as we have performed the great training, it will be going to give as an output as a dog only. Okay. Yeah, so like as I told you, like we can make the machine learning models in a different way. Like it is not necessary that you can make the dog and the cat classifier only. You can make a different things. You can make a like anything. Like if you want to, if you want to mix the dog breeds classifier, so you can make that too. Like you can give the different images of a dogs, like the of a different breeds, the Labrador, the German Shepherd. Right, the different breeds you can give, and based on that given image, it will going to give you the output, like which kind of a breed it is, right? So isn't it so amazing? In the machine learning, we can perform multiple things. The more you explore, you will going to learn a lot. Yeah, yeah. So with the help of the machine learning, what you can do, you can also make a different games. Like it is not necessary we can just going to classify the animals only. No, not at all. The more you explore, the more you learn. Like here we can do the lot of things. Here like you can see the rock, paper, scissor game. So with the help of a machine learning, you can also the games like the rock, paper, scissor game, where you will show with the hand as a rock, the symbol of a rock, the paper and the scissor like this, and it will going to predict your move, like whatever the move you played, whether it is rock, paper, scissor, and accordingly the computer will going to play its own move. And once it's played its move, then it will going to show you the winner, like who is the winner, like whether the you can be the winner, like the player or the computer can be the winner. This is a very wonderful project. Yes. And with the help of this project, you can make a really wonderful different projects too. Yes. So please try to explore the PictoVlogs, and there you can have a learn the machine learning different things also. Yeah. So let's make a mask detector. So what does the mask detector means? Like if I have wear the mask, then this it will say, please wear the mask. And if I'm not wearing the mask, what it will say? Like if I'm wear the mask, it will say like, thanks for wearing the mask. And if I'm not wear the mask, it will say, please wear a mask. As you know, in this pandemic situation, the mask is our essential need, right? So we can make such a really good project with the PictoVlogs. Okay. Yes. So don't worry, like Parth, don't worry. We will send all the links to you again. Okay, so don't worry about it. All the links will be going to send to you. But before it, just pay your attention over here only, because here we are going to learn a different things. No? So now I'm going to make an activity of a face mask detector. Okay, yeah. And after making an activity, we are going to test it, how exactly it works. Okay, so first of all, what I'm going to do, I will go to the PictoBlocks. So I'm sharing my screen of PictoBlocks. So you can visit an online web version with the help of PictoBlocks.ai. I hope my screen is properly visible to all. You can put your like response in the chat. Are you able to see it?
Yes, we can see it. Yes.
Okay. That sounds great. Yeah. Good. So now let's make a face mask detector project. So first of all, what we need to do, we need to go to the add extension. Here we have a multiple different extensions, right? So if you feel like the blocks given over there in the PictoBlocks is not sufficient, so you can go to the add extension and you can explore the different extension. There you can find a multiple different blocks. So like here I will choose the machine learning. Okay, but here you can see only two blocks are there. So as I already told you, like we in the machine learning, we can perform the two things, training and testing, right? So in the training part, we are going to train our model, and in the testing part, we are going to test our model. So for training, we will go to the create a model, and for testing, we are going to load a model. So I'm going to click on create a model. So once I click on create a model, it will directly redirect you to the teachable machine page. Okay. So on this page, basically you can perform your training. Okay, so just put your eyes on the screen, because this is an important part. Yes. Okay, so in the machine learning, we can train our project with the three different things, that can be image, audio and pose. But for now, we are going to work with the image project only. Okay, so I will go on the image project. Okay, so now this is the exact interface. So now what you need to do, first of all, here you can see the classes, yeah, the different classes. So now what you need to do, you need to basically change the name of the classes. How? Just click over here and I will just put the name of a class like mask mask. Okay, and the class 2 I will be going to give the name as unmask. Okay, like this. So now what you can do, here is the option of a webcam and the upload. Like if you are having the images in your computer or your drive, so you can directly upload it, but we can use the webcam also. So I'm using the webcam. So here you can see it is going, it my full face is visible over here, right? So now what I will going to do, I will wear the mask. Okay, so just wait for a while. Like this. So I'm going to record the number of images in different directions and in different way. Yeah. So I have taken up the sample around 180 images, right? Now in the same way, I am going to do for unmask. Okay. So in the same way also, I am going to record the multiple images. In each and every direction, just try to do it, because the more the image you will give, you will receive a good output. Okay, so after doing the after performing the just recording all the images, now what you need to do, just we need to go on train model. Okay, so once you click on train a model, your model will going to start its training automatically, but it will take some time. Okay, so just hold for 1 or 2 seconds, it will going to start automatically. Okay, so like when like here what like you know the people needs to when like we when we are a children, we don't know about the things, no, like whether what is a cat, what is a dog, right? So people shows us the images of a dogs and a cat and all these things, then at the end now any image of a dog and a cat will come in front of you, so you are able to recognize it. In the same way it happens over here. So now in the preview option you can see, as I have not wear the mask, it is just saying me unmask, right? It is predicting it as 100%. So now what I will try to do, I will try to put up the mask. So you can see as a mask image is, even the mask image is coming, like a small image is coming like this. So it is just appearing it as a mask, right? Yeah. So here in the preview option, you can check your model whether it is working fine or not. If it is not working fine, then you can just recapture the images. You can recreate the class. You can delete the class and upload the things again, right? So that in the preview you can check whether it is working fine or not. So once you have done that, don't forget to just turn off the input. Okay, then click on export a model, because the training is completed. Now we need to perform the testing, so we are going to export our model. So click on export my model, then a pop-up screen will going to be appear like this. Okay, then once this screen will going to come, what you need to do, you basically need to go on upload my model. Okay, so your model will going to upload and a link will going to be appear over here. See, the shareable link is available and you can copy that link, right? The link is available over here, so just click on copy. Okay, so now you can go on your PictoBlocks. So here what I am going to do now, as I go on my PictoBlocks, so I already told you, create a model is for training purpose and load a model is for testing purpose. So I am going to go on load my model, and here what I need to do, copy that link, the link we have just copied from the Teachable machine. No, so we need to paste that link over here. So I will going to paste it, choose my model as an image and load my model. Yes, yeah, yes, hooray. So we have our model has been loaded successfully. So how will you get to know your models has been loaded or not? Like here you can see image model and all the blocks related to your model is appearing over here. You can see mask, unmask over here, right? Okay, so now let's make a program. So I will just put a Toby over here for a while. Yeah, so first of all, use the when flag clicked. Okay, so what is the use of when flag click? I think you already know, but basically I will tell you again. So whatever the code we write below when flag clicked will going to execute whenever we click on this green flag. So now what I need to do, I need to turn on video on a stage with 0% transparency. Okay, so after that, what we are going to do, we are going to check the things. Okay, so I am going to apply if else. Okay, so in the if part, what I will going to get to put is, see, this identify class from the web camera is mask. Okay, if from the web camera, if it has identified the class as a mask, then it will say, thank you for wearing mask. Okay, and in the else part, what you can do, if it is if the person has not wear the mask, it will say please wear a mask. Okay, now what we want these things into the continuous way, no? Like it will going to recognize one time and then it will stop. So what we can do, we can apply the forever block over here like this. Okay, so let's try to run the code and check whether it works or not. So it is saying me, please wear the mask, please wear the mask, right? Because I have not wear it. So now what I'm going to do, just take my mask and put it up here. So it's saying, thank you for wearing the mask. Thank you for wearing the mask, right? When I remove it, it will say, please wear the mask, right? So have you seen how easy it is? Like once we perform the training perfectly, then all the things are very much easy, right? What you just need to do, just remember the things, how we export a model, how we just copy that link and just paste it into the load model. I tell you again, like machine learning works into the two frame, training and testing. Create a model is for training and load a model is for testing. Once you perform the training, then you need to copy the link from there and paste into the machine learning and the load my model, right? And once it's get load, you need to write your model, like your program over here, right? So in the first part we have seen, no, like input, model and output. So here I'm going to give the input image of a mine. Then the model is just recognizing all these things and giving me the output like, yeah, you have wear the mask or you have not wear the mask, right? So I hope you have enjoyed these things. Yes, if yes, please just show me the thumbs up in the chat. Yeah. So we have successfully just test our project completely, right? We have successfully test our project completely. Okay. So now let's move to the next part. Now, what is a post detection? When we are going to the teachable machine, the third option you have seen, there is a pose, right? The pose detection. So the way, in the same way we have made our face mask detector using an image detection, no? In the same way we can work with the pose detection. In the same way we can work with the pose detection. Okay, so in the pose detections, what happened? Train the computer to identify different human pose and make a interactive projects. Okay, like here you can see in the first image, you can see the baseball player is just throwing a ball. And what are that, the dots and the lines? So in the pose project, how the pose project is basically different from a machine learning, the image project. In the image, there is no lines and dots. It is totally capturing the images, but in the post project, it will going to find out the dots and the lines. The dots are basically the joints and the lines are basically your body parts like a hand, legs, right? So all these things are basically, it will going to connect that joints with the that line and will going to make a perfect pose. And with the help of that pose, you can identify the multiple, you can just make the multiple things like the jumping jacks project. That yesterday the Ayush sir has explained you, like how the person is just jumping and it is counting how many jumping jacks it has done. In the same way, you can also find out the yoga poses, right? You are doing the yoga and how many times you have performed these things, right? Yeah. So I hope that you have understand the pose detections, right? I think Harsh Sharma has given a message, sir, there are 62 landmarks. No, Harsh Sharma, in the face recognizations, there are predefined 68 landmarks. Yeah. Okay, fine. So, yeah. So I hope you have enjoyed the part of it. Yes, I hope you have enjoyed how we can make the pose detection based different projects and all. Right? you have learned a wonderful things over here, how we can make a different projects in machine learning, right? How we can make how we can just use the post detection related things, right? All these things we have learned in a very well manner. So now in the same way, you can just try to make a different projects into your PictoBlocks application or in your dot like on the web version. You can make a multiple projects, like in the way we have just make the face mask detector, you can try with the animal breed detector, right? You can try with that. Even you can try with the waste detector, like whether the waste is a biodegradable waste or a non-biodegradable waste, right? So you can perform multiple activities, but performing the activity, but before performing the activities, you will really need to know about how the things works in the PictoBlocks, right? So just explore the things, learn the things, and try to make the wonderful projects. And you're going to learn a lot of things. Yes. So now if anyone is having any doubt, questions, so you can put in the chat. I'm here to answer you. Partha Dixit, it's not coming to upload the image model. So like what you need to do, go on the create a model. Okay. From there, it will going to redirect you to the teachable machine. And on the teachable machine, there is a three option: image model, prose model, and audio model. So you can choose the image model. If you are having any other doubt, ask. Yes, we are going to send you all the links again. Don't worry about it. All the links, replay link, quirky link, all the links you will be going to get. Don't worry about it. Yes.
Yeah, so thank you, Charlene. Let me just give you a little understanding to all the students about the competition as well. So as you already know that we are also having a competition going on. So let me just share my screen and show you a little about competition. Although we have discussed about this on both the days. So students, you already know that this is the last day for this camp. I should say this celebration of Scratch Week with PictoBlocks. After this, now we want you all to come up with your own project. So you have been attending this sessions for all 3 days. It's really wonderful. We thank you for that. And also now we are going to share you the link on the chat box, and also you will be receiving it on your emails. So you have to submit your project video, which project video link from YouTube basically. Okay, and I'll just share you the link, just give me a moment. Before sharing the link for the submission, let me again remind you of the wonderful prizes you will be getting. So you will be getting a prize, a Quirky Innovators kit and the certificate. So all the students who have attended will be receiving the certificates only once they submit their project video link, which has been uploaded to the YouTube, to the form we will be sharing to you. So let me now stop the share here and just share you the link and just hand over the stage to Jennifer to just let us know more about the Quirky.
Hello everyone, I hope I am audible to you.
Yes.
Okay, first of all, thank you so much, Ayush, and thank you so much, Mr. Charlene, for such a wonderful explanation. I hope everyone would have understood that what machine learning is, how to train the machine by performing the small activity. Also, you might have got a decent idea from the webinar series that what is programming, its benefits, along with understanding what AI is and the different techniques of its use. The replay link of the entire learned coding from scratch will be sent in the chat box so that in case you missed out on the previous webinars, or if you want to go through them, you can go through them again. As you must be aware by now that we don't want to preach, we don't want just to preach theory to you. We want you to apply it by making projects of your own and submit them to the competition. And as Mr. Ayush mentioned, the winners will be receiving an exciting AI and robotics kit, Quirky. So let me play a small video for you.
Meet Quirky. It's a gesture-controlled robot. No. A smart gardening system? No, wait. An autonomous delivery truck? No. A Mars rover. Actually, it's all this rolled into one.
Hi, Quirky.
Hi, Jay.
It's an AI and robotics learning companion for the next generation. Quirky takes children on an exciting journey to explore advanced concepts on AI and robotics with an easy, engaging, and hands-on approach. It is packed with interactive online courses and engaging live sessions that help children to learn, code, and make their own real-world projects. In other words, one Quirky, endless possibilities. Quirky is portable. Carry Quirky around and control it using your laptop, tablet, or even a smartphone. It's easy to program, whether you're a coding newbie using blocks or an expert using Python. Comes with a plug-and-play interface, making it hassle-free and with some of the coolest latest tech. So imagine a self-driving car, which identifies street signs and pedestrians. Or a faithful robot dog that follows commands with the help of machine learning and object detection. It's evident that Quirky is for everyone who wants to be ahead of the curve.
Ready to explore the universe of AI and robotics with me?
I hope that video was very interesting for you. A few minutes to talk about it. Quirky is a reprogrammable AI robotic kit that allows you to bring your code to life. It's a pocket-sized board to help you make a variety of AI and machine learning projects, from self-driving car to waste collectors, from weather monitoring system to expression replicators and whatnot. And you can make these wonders from the comfort of your home. We will be launching Quirky globally on Kickstarter about a month from now, and we want you to reap the maximum benefits from the same. And to ensure that, we are inviting you for joining the exclusive subscribers list. You can join the same by registering yourself at the link given in the chat box. With this, Learn Coding from Scratch webinar series ends here. But the Scratch Week does not. You do have time till the 20th May to submit your projects and stand a chance to win the AI robot kit. I'd like to thank all of you for joining and would also thank our presenters, Mr. Ayush and Mr. Shaling, for sharing their knowledge. Thank you, everyone. Stay safe.
Thank you, everyone. Thanks, Jennifer, for providing such a good information for the student, teachers, and parents. So, students, as we mentioned, please don't forget to submit your projects on the link given below. I will be stopping your chat and we're sharing all the links again so that you can keep it with you. Yeah. So I'll just paste some of the links. The links again to download the PictoBlocks is here in your laptop and the PC. You can just go to Google Play Store and download the PictoBlocks in your Android phones with this link to explore the web version of the PictoBlocks. Please do not forget to visit our website, that is pictoblocks.ai. And of course, the most important, please submit your forms. Please submit your YouTube video links on the form. So hope you have all enjoyed the session, and we will be contacting you soon through the email also for these links, and you will be receiving the emails. You will be receiving the links on your email. Do not forget to go through with them. So I think Jennifer has posted one more link for you all students. So do not forget to register the Quarky subscriber link here on the chat box. Thank you all for joining on this session, and thanks again. Bye-bye.
Bye, everyone.
Everyone.